Hello dear students, welcome back to our bio class, and today we'll discuss about the another type of animal tissues that are found in all the animals, and the tissues are connective tissues. Earlier we discussed about the epithelial tissues, and you have seen in animals epithelial tissues, they provide the outer covering as well as internal covering. They also provide the covering of all the body organs, whether internal or external, right? So now we talk about the another type of tissues. These are known as connective tissues. The connective tissues are basically they are basic packing tissues, or you can say they are package tissues. They are responsible for packing the all body parts together. So in every connective tissue, there are basically two components. One is the larger part, that is matrix, and these matrix may be solid, liquid, or it may be jelly like. So the matrix of these connective tissues may be solid, liquid, or jelly like viscous, and in matrix the cells remain embedded, and these cells are responsible for performing their specific functions. The matrix component of the connective tissue is non-living component, whereas of course these cells are the living component of the connective tissues. So if you look at the location of these connective tissues, they are found all over the body. You can say that is the most widely spread tissue present in animal body. So their function is, as the name suggests itself, they connect the various body parts together. The function of connective tissues, the most important function of connective tissues, as the name itself suggests, that they are responsible for connecting the various body parts together, and because of that connection together, they provide rigidity to the body. Of course, they provide support to the various body parts. They also help in transportation of various materials from one part of the body to another. And another important function is they provide a definite shape to the body. They are also responsible for storage. They are also responsible for absorption of various materials, and so on. So that is just an introduction about the functions being performed by the various connective tissues. Depending upon their positions, depending upon their functions, they may have different kinds of arrangement, and based on that different kinds of arrangement, they have different functions. So today here in this lecture, we'll be discussing about the various kinds of connective tissues that can be observed in an animal body. So, first type of connective tissue here is the areolar connective tissue. The areolar connective tissue is again most widely spread in the body. In the whole body, it is dispersed over here and there, and it is performing its specific function. If we look at the location and function of this areolar tissue, it is found below the skin, around kidneys, etc. And it contains the matrix, which is jelly-like matrix. And it's if you look at the function of areolar tissue, as I have already said, yeah, that it is performing some important functions like binding the various organs together and packaging tissue. So if you look at the functions of areolar tissue, so its most important function is it binds the organs together, and it also helps in repair of body or tissue at the time of injury, and also helps in fighting infections, or you can say it provides immunity to the body, right? So that is about the areolar tissue. And second type of connective tissues which we can observe here in animals is the adipose tissue. Adipose tissue are basically, they are the fat storage tissues, and if you look their position, their cells are large, oval and swollen due to absorption or due to accumulation of fat globules. So fat storage tissues with large oval cells due to fat storage. The cells here are known as adipocytes. If you look at the location of these adipose tissues, they are found again below the skin and between internal organs. And the function of these tissues is, of course, as you have seen, they are responsible for storage of fats. Other than that, they also provide insulation to the body. They provide a definite shape to the body. And they also act as shock absorbers to various parts of the body. So here I have given you idea about two types of connective tissues. The first one is areolar connective tissue, the most widely connective tissue found in a body, and it is found below the skin, around the kidneys, etc. And as I have already said, that all these connective tissues are having some matrix. So here the matrix of these areolar connective tissue is jelly-like. And if you look at the function, the most important function is it binds the various organs together. And due to this binding, it provides a definite shape to the body. It provides rigidity and support to the body. It also helps in repair of body at the time of injury. So if there are any injury or any damage in the body, that damage is repaired with the help of areolar connective tissue. And also, it also helps in developing immunity to the body, as it helps in fighting the various infections or various microorganisms entering to our body. The next type of tissues are known as adipose tissues. Adipose tissues are another type of connective tissues, and their main function is to store the fat. So they are basically fat storage tissues, and they store fat in the form of droplets, fat droplets or fat globules. And due to absorption of fat or due to storage of fat, the cells of these tissues are large, oval and swollen. And because of absorption of storage of fats, the cells of adipose tissues are also known as adipocytes. So if you look at the function of location of these adipose tissues, they can be found all over the body below the skin, and they also occupy the space between the internal organs, right? That's why it provides a protection to the internal organs and keep the internal organs fixed on their respective positions, right? And look at the function. Of course, the most important function is the storage. As you have seen, they store the fats. Another one is insulation. As they are a good conductor of heat, fats are bad conductor of heat, so they help in maintaining our body temperature, and it provides insulation against external environment. And the fat also provides a definite shape to our body. And these adipose tissue, they act as shock absorber, so that they protect the various inner organs and various delicate parts of the body. So that is all about the another type of connective tissues. Some more type of connective tissues are there after areolar and adipose tissues. The another type of connective tissues are tendons and ligaments. So next type of connective tissues are tendons, and then we'll discuss about ligaments. So if we look at the position and functions of these tendons and ligaments, tendons are another type of connective tissues. Their main function is to connect muscles to the bones. So tendons are what? It is again dense fibrous connective tissue which connects muscles to the bones. So its main function is to provide connection between the muscle and bone. The hard tissue, hard and non-elastic, or better you can say it is a strong and non-elastic tissue. It is strong but not elastic, does not provide any elasticity to the body. And if you look at the positions of these tissues, they are found over as a covering of bones and cartilage. So they are providing coverings of bones and cartilage. And in that case, what happens? They provide protection to the bones and cartilage. Another type of connective tissue which you can observe here in animals is the ligaments. These tissues are strong and highly elastic. And join bones to bones. Act joints. Right? And if you look at the function, due to elasticity, they provide bending and rotating movements of bone over joints. So these are the another two more type of connective tissues. The one is tendon. Tendon, as you have seen, what is the function of tendons? They are the dense fibrous connective tissue, and their main function is to connect muscle to the bones. And as you know, the movement of our body parts is possible because of the joint effects of the muscular system and the skeletal system. So in that case, there must be some connection between the two parts. So that connection between the muscles and bones is provided by the tendons. So these tissues are strong but non-elastic, right? They are found only generally as the covering over the bones and cartilage, and their main function is to provide protection to the bones and cartilage. Then we have another type of connective tissue that is known as ligament. Ligament, in contrast to tendons, are highly elastic. So these tissues are strong, highly elastic, and they can be found at the bone joints. So at the joints of our bones, the two bones are connected together with the help of ligaments. And as you have seen, that ligaments are highly elastic. So because of this elasticity, it is possible that we are capable of rotating our bones or moving our bones over our joints. So the movement of our bones over our joints, this has been possible only because of the another type of connective tissues, and these connective tissues are known as ligament, right? Then another type of connective tissues which you can observe in case of animal bodies is the cartilage and bones. See, till now, the connective tissues which we were talking about, like the areolar tissue, adipose tissue, and tendons and ligaments, they are basically what? They are basically known as packaging tissue. They connect one part of the body to another, but also they are responsible for packing the various body parts together. Whereas cartilage and bone are two known as skeletal connecting tissues. So cartilage is a skeletal tissue. It is generally soft. So the matrix of cartilage has got specific type of proteins, and because of that this cartilage tissue is comparatively soft. And if you look at their locations, so they are forming covering at the tips of long bones. The bones which are quite long, for example the bones of her limbs like hands and legs, in these longer bones the tips are covered with the help of cartilage. In that case, cartilage, what does when the two bones, they move over each other, when there is a joint movement, so this cartilage protects the bones against any wear and tear. Other than that, cartilage can also be found in pinna. Pinna means the external ear. It can also be found around trachea. It is also found in epiglottis. So pinna is the external ear, and you can see our external ear is very soft. You can easily bend it. That is due to presence of cartilage in it. Trachea, that is our windpipe, is surrounded by the cartilaginous rings, which are known as rings of cartilage. So what do these rings of cartilage do? They ensure that windpipe is always wide open. Whenever, if by any chance there is no air in the windpipe, so in these case, these rings of cartilage, that help the windpipe from getting collapsed, right? It doesn't allow the windpipe to collapse. And another one you have seen, it is also present in epiglottis. Epiglottis is what? Epiglottis is a small leaf-like covering which is made up of cartilage and covering over a windpipe. So as you know, in our neck region, the food pipe and windpipe, they run parallelly. So in order to ensure that while swelling in the food, no food particle enters to the windpipe. So in that case, what happens when you are swallowing the food, the epiglottis covers the windpipe, ensuring that no food particle is entering to the windpipe. And that's why you are always suggested that you should not talk while swallowing or while eating the food. And if by any chance any food particle goes into your windpipe, then suddenly we have strong cough. It is a system of our body, so to push out that food particle from a windpipe, right? So it is found in epiglottis. It is also found in nasal septum. So as you have seen that in our nose, we are having a partition which separates the two nostrils from each other, the left and right nostril. So the partition which is separating the two nostrils is also made up of cartilage, right? So these are the various positions of cartilage. If you look at the functions of cartilage, so its function is, first of all, it protects the long bones from wear and tear. You can say better that it protects the tips of the long bone from wear and tear, so that you don't get any damage, right? And the another function of cartilage is that it supports the various body parts together. Right? even in some fishes, which are also known as cartilaginous fishes, their whole endoskeleton is made up of cartilage. That's why they are having a soft texture, right? And next type of skeletal tissue is bone. Bones are another type of skeletal tissues, but the major difference between the cartilage and bones is that the cartilage is a soft skeletal tissue, whereas bones are hard. So they are hard due to the hard matrix. Made up of carbonates and phosphates of calcium, right? So the bone matrix is a hard matrix which is made up of either calcium carbonate or calcium phosphate. That's why you are advised to take plenty of milk so that you get plenty of calcium in your body, and that calcium makes your body strong, makes your bones strong. And of course the bone cells remain embedded in the matrix and in very long bones there is a hollow portion and that hollow portion is known as marrow, or you can call it bone marrow, right? So if you look at the locations of the bones, so where will you find the bones? They form the endoskeleton of all vertebrates. So bones can be found in the body of all vertebrate animals, and there in all vertebrate animals bones are forming their endoskeleton. Now if you look at the function, bones are performing some very very important functions. Of course they act as skeletal framework of body. So the whole body system is based on the framework of a skeletal system, and that skeletal system is made up of bones. And of course due to that they provide a definite shape to the body. All animals as well as human beings, they have a definite shape, as we have got a vertical posture, and that vertical posture is due to presence of the skeletal system. If that skeletal system was not there, our body was not going to have a definite shape. Also another important function of bones is, other than these two, they store the minerals like calcium and phosphorus. As you have seen that the matrix of bones is made up of calcium phosphate and calcium carbonate, so they are responsible for storing these minerals in them. Then another important function of bones is they provide protection, protect the delicate body parts. So the whole skeletal system is responsible for protecting the various delicate body parts of a body. For example, as you know, some very common and very important parts of our body are heart, brain and lungs. And these all three parts are protected by our skeletal system. For example, if you talk about the brain is protected by the bony covering, and that bony covering is known as skull. So the brain is a highly important and crucial part of the body, which coordinates all the functions of our body, and that is protected by the skull, that is bony covering. Similarly, heart and lungs are another two very important part, and they are protected by the rib cage. And of course, rib cage is what, that is also the part of skeletal system made up of bones, right? So, and one more important function that bones have got other than these cells of bone marrow produce blood cells like RBCs. So another major important function of bones, that the bone marrow of long bones, the cells of bone marrow of long bones, they are responsible for producing the various cells of blood, that is especially if we talk about RBCs, right? So that is another type of skeletal connective tissue present in our body. The next type of connective tissue is the blood is another connective tissue which is mainly transportive tissue, because its function is to transport the various materials from one part of the body to another. Like any connective tissue, here in blood also there is a matrix. The matrix is liquid matrix, and that liquid matrix is known as plasma, which contains proteins, enzymes and hormones, etc. Right? And the blood cells are basically of three types of cells there, and these blood cells are RBCs or red blood corpuscles, WBCs or white blood corpuscles, and another one are platelets. So blood flows all over our body. You can say around 8 to 9% of our body weight is because of blood. And in plasma, around 50% of the plasma is containing water, right? So if we look at the function of all these cells, so first type of cells are RBCs, which are also known as erythrocytes. Erythrocytes or RBCs, they contain hemoglobin, which provides red color to the blood. The another type of cells here are WBCs or white blood corpuscles, which are also known as leukocytes, and their main function is to provide immunity to our body or you can say to fight against various microorganisms or various infections entering to our body. And third type of cells here are platelets, which are also known as thrombocytes, and their main function is help in clotting of blood during any leakage. So whenever we get some cuts, wounds, or sometimes there is internal bleeding also, so these platelets or thrombocytes to ensure that the loss of blood can be prevented as soon as possible by clotting the blood. And this blood loss prevention is highly important, because in this case, what is going to happen, if body is continuously going to lose the blood, in that case it is going to lose the important nutrients also, important materials also from our body. And also, if there is less blood in our body, it is going to increase the burden on our heart also, right? So that is about the various components of the blood. If we look at the functions of blood, first of all, it is responsible for transport of gases other nutrients and waste materials from one part of body to another. For example, you have seen the oxygen from lungs is transported to various cells and tissues of the body by means of blood. Carbon dioxide is collected from various parts of the body by means of blood. The digested nutrients are taken from the digestive system from small intestine and transferred to various parts of the body. The waste material is also collected from various cells of the body by blood and is brought back to the kidneys or the excretory system, from where that waste can be released out, right? And another important function of blood is it helps in regulating body temperature. So it maintains body temperature. Blood is responsible for that maintenance also. Then another important function of blood is that it regulates the amount of water in our body. So these are some of the important functions of the liquid connective tissue. The liquid connective tissue found in our body is the blood, and you have seen this blood has got various components, and each component is having its own function, right? Then another important component or you can say important connective tissue of the body is the lymph. That is also the liquid connective tissue. So next type of liquid connective tissue which can be seen in our body is lymph. It is also a transportive tissue. responsible for transportation of various materials from one part of the body to another, and another liquid connective tissue, or it is also known as filtered blood. As the lymph is having almost the same composition as the blood, the only difference is, you can say, the composition of lymph is same as blood, except the only difference is that in lymph there are no RBCs, no platelets, and less proteins. So otherwise, all other component of the lymph is approximately same as that of blood. And you have seen the only difference in the lymph is that it is not having RBCs, it is not having platelets, and there is less protein content in the lymph. Like blood flows in blood capillaries and blood vessels, similarly, lymph flows in lymph capillaries and lymph vessels, and finally drained into blood back. So all the material which is taken from blood is finally mixed back into the blood. And if you look at the functions of lymph, you can say it acts as a middleman for exchange of substances, between blood and body tissues. And another function is, it also provides immunity to the body. So these all are the functions of lymph. Another type of liquid connective tissue, which is also purely transportive in nature, transports various materials from one part of the body to another. It's, you can say, a kind of filtered blood. The blood which is devoid of RBCs, which is devoid of platelets, and which is containing less protein as compared to blood. So its composition is same as that of blood. And it, like blood flows in blood capillaries and blood vessels, similarly lymph flows in lymph capillaries and lymph vessels. And any exchange which occurs between the blood and body tissues, that all is governed with the help of lymph, or you can that all exchange takes place via lymph. And another function of the lymph is provides immunity to the body. And another function of lymph is, it helps in transport of digested fats. The fats which are digested in the body of in the small intestine, finally are absorbed by the lymph and they are transported to various parts of the body. So that is all about the connective tissues present in our body. In next lecture, we'll be discussing about the another type of important tissues, and these are muscular tissues or muscle cells or muscle fibers that are responsible for making the movement of our body possible. Right? So have a nice time. Goodbye till then.